Hello children, a pleasant good morning to you all. Is everyone ready? Good. Now we are learning block 12, air and us. Let's take a look at previous topics. First, properties of air. Air is colorless and odorless. We cannot see or smell it, but we can feel it when it blows. These are a few properties of air. We learned some more properties of air through activities that are: air occupies space, it does not have any shape. It takes the shape of the closed container in which it is kept. And air has weight. Next, air exerts pressure. We saw an experiment using glass and cardboard, isn't it? In that, air in the surroundings exerted upward force on the cardboard and balanced out the downward force of the water. This made the cardboard stick to the glass, thus not allowing the water spill out. We can conclude that air exerts pressure. The force applied by air on a unit area is of surface is called air pressure. The layers of air around us form the atmosphere. So, this pressure can also be called atmospheric pressure. It applies pressure on all objects on earth. Okay? The atmosphere exerts pressure on our bodies, but our bodies also exerts an equal amount of pressure in the outward direction. The pressure in our bodies is equal to the pressure outside our bodies, hence creating a balance. So, we do not crumble under atmospheric pressure. Okay? Next, use of pressure. When we suck water or juice through the straw, we suck air first. It reduces the air pressure inside the straw. The air which is outside exerts more pressure on the water and pushes it in the straw. Similarly, when we press the dropper, the air pressure inside gets reduced. The air pressure outside increases and pushes the water inside the dropper. Suction pump. When we press the suction pump, the air beneath it escapes. The air pressure outside is more and presses the pump against the wall. The difference in air pressure helps in all the activities we did. Some examples from real life where we use the difference in air pressure are filling syringes, filling cycle tubes, pistons, sprinklers, cisterns, vacuum cleaners, and hand pumps. These things also work because of air pressure. The compressed air in tires of all automobiles exerts more pressure on the roads and helps the vehicles to move smoothly. These are the points we discussed in the previous class. Before starting today's class, make sure that you having all the needed resources, that are content book and workbook of volume 2 and your notebook. Now, let's begin today's class. What do you breathe in and what do you breathe out? Yes, we breathe air. We breathe in air and breathe out air. How could you survive in a place where there is no air? We cannot, isn't it? We cannot survive in a place where there is no air. How would plants survive there? Where there is no air? Plants also cannot survive without air. Today, we will learn about some more ways in which air is beneficial for us. So, the aim is to conclude that air helps in burning. Put the video on pause and write the aim in your notebook. I hope you have completed it. Come on, let's start today's topic. More uses of air. This is the keyword we will use in this topic. Extinguish.
Extinguish. Extinguish. Extinguish.
I hope you learned the pronunciation of the keyword. Now we will learn the meaning of the keyword. Extinguish. That means to stop a burning fire. Extinguished means cause the fire to stop burning. Okay? I believe you learned the meaning of the keyword. Now you can write the keyword and its meaning in your notebook. I hope you have completed it. Next is an activity. For that, needed resources are a plate, candle, glass jar, and matchstick. Shall we start the activity? Come on. First, keep a plate on the table and place a candle on the plate and light the candle. After some time, cover it with a glass and observe. Write your observations in the notebook. Come on, let's see what happened to the candle. The flame was extinguished. Isn't it? Along this video, I have posted another video that shows the experiment air helps in burning. Put this video on pause and watch the demonstration video. After that, come back to this video. I hope you watched the demonstration video. Now tell me, what happened to the candle before we kept it in the glass jar? What happened to the candle before we kept it in the glass jar? Yes, it was light. The candle was light before we kept it in the glass jar. What happened to the candle after we kept it in the glass jar? It was extinguished, right? The flame was extinguished after we covered it with the glass jar. What could have been the reason for these changes? How do you think? Yes, the air got exhausted. Earlier there was air, whereas later the air got exhausted inside the jar. It is clear from this activity that when the candle was exposed to air, it kept burning. And when it was inside the glass jar with no air supply, it got extinguished. So, the conclusion is air helps in burning. Before covering the candle with glass jar, there was air, whereas later the air got exhausted inside the jar. Okay, what can we conclude about air from this activity? What was the conclusion of this activity? Yes, air is necessary for burning. From the above activity, we can say that air is necessary for burning. Burning anything is possible only in the presence of air. How does air help in burning? What do you think? How does air help in burning? It has oxygen, right? Air has oxygen which supports burning. Air is also used to rotate the fans of windmills to produce electricity. Okay? Next, hot question. Why is sand used to extinguish fire? Why is sand used to extinguish fire? Put the video on pause Think and write the answer in your notebook. I hope you have completed it. Let's see the answer. Sand is used as an extinguisher because it covers the thing which has caught fire and cuts its contact with air. Things cannot burn without air. Okay? Soil cuts the thing which has caught fire contact with air. So, things cannot burn without air. So, sand is used to extinguish fire. Did you get it? Good. Next, practice questions. Question number 7 and 8 are your today's homework. The questions are, why do our ears pop when we go to high altitudes? Next question, why is this balloon not being filled? There is a picture. Why is the balloon in the picture not being filled? Next, worksheet questions. In S4, first question, how is air necessary for the survival of plants? How is air necessary for the survival of plants? Second question, look at the experiment and answer the following questions. We saw an experiment using candle in the demonstration video, right? Look at the experiment and answer the questions below. Question number 2A is, explain this setup. Question number 2B, what did you observe from the experiment? Question number 2C, what can you conclude from this experiment? And the last question, a fire extinguisher gives out carbon dioxide when used on a burning object. How does this help to extinguish the fire? How does the fire extinguisher help to extinguish the fire? Answer the practice questions in your notebook, worksheet questions in your workbook. Next, question of the day. Today our question is, plants need dash present in the air to make their food. Plants need dash present in the air to make their food. Next, an open question to answer in the comment section. What happened to the candle after we kept it in the glass jar? What happened to the candle after we kept it in the glass jar? Answer this question in the comment section. That's all for today. Do your homework regularly. After completing your homework, get a sign from your parents in the planner. Do your homeworks daily. Don't keep pending work. Thank you for listening. Have a good day. God bless you.